All right, Baselli to approach the ball to kick it off for Stanford. Deep for San Jose State in the open end of the stadium are Jamar Julian and Casey LeBlanc. Deontay Whitaker, normally one of their kick returners, so the Spartans lose him on that part of their game today.
Mike Baselli was with us at Council of Chiefs yesterday at the Sheraton, and he comes forward to kick.
And he lets it go. It's going to be short to the far side of the field and out of bounds. Wasn't so good.
We talked to him about that. He wanted to talk about the ones that went beyond the end zone more than those sidewinders. That one puts the ball out on the 35 for the Cardinal. The Stanford captains today, Pitts, Chris Johnson,
always
Frank Primus.
Always played by rule, the 35-yard line, first down.
And Mike McLaughlin, the center.
All right, so for San Jose in their white jerseys with blue pants, gold trim, Chris Costello, a senior, is the quarterback. They come out in a four wide receiver set. Patrick Battle is the running back, although Darian Morton expected to get the bulk of the time. And Costello fumbles the snap, hands the ball to Battle in the middle of the line. He drives forward to gain 3, maybe 4 yards, with Austin Lee starting for Stanford today. How about that, Austin Lee?
Well, we've liked Austin.
Yeah, he's starting for Sam Benner. I believe that's the first time Lee has started.
Yeah, he's that big guy from Coeur d'Alene, and he has a lot of Stanford football ahead of him, and he's going to fill it with some glory, I believe.
So Lee, Howard, Curry, and Rial Johnson, four down men up front for Stanford. Second and 7, Spartans, 5 wide receivers from their own 38. Three-step drop, flat pass near side, caught by LeBlanc. 40, 45 up the near sideline to midfield, first down. Just shy, a football length shy of midfield. 4 wideouts again. So the Spartans going no tight end here early. Now, 3-step drop. Pass near side, caught by Pulley to the 44 of Stanford. Spun around by Chris Johnson and driven out of bounds. That is Steve Pulley, a senior, making the tackle. And so Dave Baldwin using this attack where the short pass acts like the running game.
That's exactly. It's an extension of the running game. Sean Brewer, the big tight end for the Spartans, was with us at the luncheon on Monday, and he doesn't much like this, 2 wide receivers on either side, because that pretty much excludes the tight end. He doesn't like that.
Well, he said something pretty stupid himself in the newspaper the other day. Second down and 4 rather from the 44. Costello throws far side, incomplete, intended for LeBlanc on a turnout, covered by Frank Primus. As Brewer, he came apparently, I guess, in casual attire, and the Stanford players came rather nicely dressed, and Brewer said, I guess some programs have money or something like that. That's a comment that the young man would be better served to be unsaid.
Yeah, he didn't need to say that.
All right, third down almost 4 from the Stanford 44-yard line. 4 down men for the Cardinal. 4 wideouts for the Spartans, 2 split each side. Costello fakes the draw, now gives the ball. It's going to be a running play for a first down all the way to the 31 of Stanford. And Casey LeBlanc, who was a wide receiver, lined up in the backfield and took the handoff on a draw play.
LeBlanc is not hard to find. He's number 1, and he's a very versatile kind of a player. He'll pop up in all kinds of places. They like to run end arounds to him. He's done that very successfully, and he's also an outstanding receiver. And once again, wide receivers, 2 each on either side.
Stanford going straight, 4 down linemen and 5 defensive backs. Costello, 3-step drop, quick slant over the middle, incomplete. That ball almost picked off by Chris Johnson, intended for LeBlanc. So defensively, to adjust to what San Jose State's going, Murph, no Sam Benner, Austin Lee is a down lineman, and Rial Johnson's playing down as well, and no Marcus Hoover in the game.
And notice, Ted, this very definitely is the quick passing game. This is a 2 or 3-step drop, quick unloading. Costello does not want to be blitzed. He's only got 5 people in front of him. It's easy for Stanford to outman him up front, but he's too quick with the ball.
Second and 10, Costello with a deep drop. Fires over the head of the intended receiver near side, Pulley. And out of bounds, incomplete, intended for Pulley, rather, covered by Chris Johnson.
Yeah, and Johnson did a great job that time. Johnson very, very close to the receiver that time, right next to Pulley. And I think the quarterback, Costello, very definitely threw that ball away.
So now Stanford brings Ryan Fernandez in, takes Shark Esteen out. So the Cardinal will go with 6 defensive backs, only 1 linebacker. That's Stockbauer, and 4 down linemen.
3 people in the box.
Now Rial Johnson standing up, so you're right, only 3 down linemen. Shotgun, 3rd and 10, Costello takes the snap, looking, fires over the middle, and it's incomplete, broken up, intended for LeBlanc, and a good cover play there by Frank Primus, jarred that ball free at the 22.
Yeah, Frank had a chance really for the interception as the receiver and the defender that time struggling with the football. They held it in suspension actually for a moment, Ted, before the ball finally dropped to the turf. And this would be a long field goal attempt. This is at the 31-yard line, and
they're not going to do it.
They're not going to do it.
They're going to go for it.
Be into a little breeze from that distance, too.
So San Jose State going, fourth and 10, Stanford 31. Battle in the game is the lone setback. Casteller goes back to throw, keeping people in the block. Throws near side, first down, 15-yard line.
Boy, he was wide open that time. Made the move on Chris Johnson right at the sideline. Wide open that time. That's Pulley.
Steve Pulley with the catch. So Dave Baldwin right away showing he's going to be a gambler today. Fourth and 10. And it was really, and punting there wouldn't have served much of a purpose.
No, would have only gained a few yards at most.
The field goal probably out of their range. So now it's first down at the Stanford 15-yard line. A 16-yard pass on fourth down.
Tight end is in there on the right side now.
Battle the lone back. Three wide receivers in the game. They turn, they give the ball to Battle straight ahead. Big hole up the middle, 10, 5, touchdown.
15-yard touchdown straight ahead, trap blocking up front. And boy, did they surprise the Cardinal. The Cardinal defense that time, Ted, looking for nothing but the pass.
So it only took San Jose State 2 minutes and 5 seconds to go 65 yards for the touchdown. Extra point by the left-footed place kicker, Tim Morgan, is good. And so we have timeout on the field, 12:55 to go first quarter. San Jose State 7, Stanford nothing on the Stanford Football Radio Network. Now Morgan kicks high and short near side. Ryan Wells fields at 19-yard line up the near side, 25, 30, got blocking, 35, out to the 40 and run out of bounds. San Jose State's Tim Morgan is much like Kevin Miller of Stanford last year. He doesn't have a very strong leg and his kickoffs have not gone very deep. And there's a perfect example. Stanford was ready for it. They had Walters deep, but they had two short men, Durrani Pitts and Ryan Wells, and they end up running the ball out to the 40-yard line.
Yeah, you wonder if you might be more effective squibbing the ball rather than hitting that little soft flasher up there, because that just invites a run back, and Wells made the best of it.
All right, here's Borchardt under center now. Casey Moore, the fullback. Kerry Carter, the tailback. And Borchardt turns, gives the ball to Carter, left side. He got about 3 yards. And then stood up by the Spartan defense.
Just one wide receiver to the right.
Yeah, two tight ends for the Cardinal. And Borchardt turns, play fake, and a bootleg to the right. Looking, not going to step up, try to run. He's to the line of scrimmage, and that's all. Brought down by the San Jose State defense. And that defensive tackle was made by Abdul Salam Noah. Third and 7, Davis left, Walters and Uso are right. Carter the lone back, Borchardt back to throw. Joe steps up, throws it, juggled and dropped by Durrani Pitts. The ball was thrown slightly behind Pitts. Borchardt got hit as he was throwing the football by Abdul Salam Noah. And so San Jose State getting a lot of emotion earlier.
I don't think he would have gotten the first down, Ted, even with the catch. Carlos Castusas was right there. And he would have made the tackle, I'm sure, short of the first down.
All right, Topenrud to punt. Walking Bailey is the lone setback for the Spartans, standing at his own 15-yard line. And here's the snap. Topenrud gets the kick away. It's a high floater, short. Bailey's going to let it bounce, 27-yard line, goes sideways and gets a good Stanford roll and goes out of bounds inside the 20. And the Spartans will be marked at about the 19-yard line here to start their second possession, leading the game 7-0. All right, here comes San Jose State. And again, Patrick Battle, the setback behind Casteller. Three wide receivers, first down from their 19. Casteller, three-step drop, quick pass far side, is caught for a gain of the 25-yard line. Wrapped up by Brian Taylor is Steve Pulley.
Very fertile offensive mind.
Second down, 4, 25-yard line. Casteller play fake, standing there, fires to the far side, caught for a first down. 34-yard line, the catch made by Walking Bailey, a junior wide receiver. San Jose State is, like Stanford, very deep at wide receiver. Maybe now the Spartans come out with that offense where LeBlanc, the wide receiver, actually lines up as the back. And they run the draw play to him again. He's this time hit behind the line, trying to bounce outside, and Austin Lee wraps him up. Well done. Austin Lee played that one very well. Tank Williams came in to help at the end. And LeBlanc will be marked for, I believe, no gain.
went to the right side. That big Austin Lee was right there to meet him.
7-0 San Jose State Spartans with second and 10 at their own 34. Now they spread the field. Five wideouts in the game. LeBlanc now throws the quick screen near side, but he overthrows LeBlanc. That was the play they ran successfully in their first possession, using the two wide receivers to block. And LeBlanc just stepped back from the line of scrimmage, but Castiller threw the ball well over his head.
Yeah.
Third down, 10. Stanford has six defensive backs on the field. Third and 10, San Jose State. Four wide receivers. Three left to the wide side, one right to the short side.
He sees the blitz and he's calling.
Now Sharkestein showing blitz. Castiller changing the play. Goes back to throw. Being blitzed and sacked, Willie Howard. Willie Howard came blowing right through the offensive front, and they sack Castiller. They'll mark it at the 27-yard line for a loss of seven and bringing up fourth down and a punt.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he changed to, Ted. That was the thing. The blitz was pretty obvious. Stanford had about seven people in the box that time. They had everybody up, and they never laid a hand on big Willie Howard, and he's so quick. He chased him down.
Now the snap to Morgan. Morgan, the left footer, punts the ball away. A good kick. Walters going way back to his 25-yard line. Far side, got one block up the far side, 30, 35, 40. Cuts back in the middle, 45, and spun to the ground finally at the 47-yard line. So a good run back, 22 yards by Troy Walters of a 48-yard punt. And thus the Stanford offense gets good field position. They'll start from their own 47-yard line.
Marlon Evans and I were talking about that in our earlier show, Ted, and your heart does, in fact, skip a beat when Walters gets his hand on the ball in those return situations, because you just know before the year's over he's going to break a few.
All right, now the Cardinal come out four wide receivers. Walters, Uso, and Davis all to the near side, which is the wide side. Carter, the lone back. Borcher turns, flag down. Carter gets the handoff and doesn't get very much. He got a yard, and the flag is going to be against Stanford also, I believe.
Offside on the defense.
Oh.
5-yard penalty. Still first down.
Well, that's help. Actually, it was at San Jose State that lined up improperly. So it's first down and five now. The ball will move to the 48 of the Spartans. You talk about a crowd that's a little shocked, Murph. How about at Notre Dame right now? In the third quarter, it is Oklahoma 30, Notre Dame 14.
Oh, boy. Bob Davey. I wonder what he's thinking about right now.
Of course, Notre Dame ends their season here. Orchard play fake. Back to throw. Looking. Now throws long. Near side. Open man. Walters has it. 25-yard line of San Jose State. All right, give Orchard some time and let Troy Walters run down the field. And, Murph, I don't think we've seen maybe USC last year, maybe the one defense that was able to really put a collar on Troy Walters.
I was checking with Dean Stotts today. Dean, of course, longtime assistant baseball coach to Mark Marquess. I asked him, I said, you know, I've often said that that ball that Borchert hit at Omaha this year was going up when it went out. He says, going up? It went over the light tower. He hit it over the light tower, he said.
First down, Spartan 25. Borchert, back three-step drop, quick slant. Pitts dropped the ball. Oh, and Durrani Pitts had room. He was at the 15-yard line, and he had a shot to take that in on that little crease through the Spartan secondary, and Durrani just dropped the ball.
Yeah, Jamar Julian was there, the defender for the Spartans, but he was about a step and a half behind Pitts, and with a clean catch, he would have run it in easily.
Now second down 10 for the Cardinal at the Spartan 25.
Beautiful throw.
Casey Morin is the fullback now in front of Carter. Pitts slot right, Davis wide right. Pitts goes in motion left. Orchard turns and gives the ball to Kerry Carter, right side. Not much there, though. The Spartans stack him up, and he gains maybe a yard. Now, we're going to take a timeout.
Timeout, Stanford.
So we'll
their first of the half.
We'll
want to go to the field goal. It would be a long one from this distance. He needs a pass completion now.
Pitts and Davis are left. Walters right. Orchard back to throw. And now being pressured, and he's going to be sacked. Now throwing the ball as he goes down, and it's going to be ruled. Let's see. It's either incomplete or a sack. And the official, the referee's got to make that judgment.
He had receivers out there. He had Pitts out there.
I'm trying to see what the ruling is, though.
He had Walters out there. They weren't near the ball. They made no call at all.
All right, so they're ruling that as an incomplete pass. Borchard was wrapped up. He had not gone down yet. He dumped the ball, and they're calling it an incomplete pass.
41-yard attempt for Mike Baselli from the right hash, and he's kicking downwind. Very slight breeze here. 3 or 4 miles an hour at the most.
All right, Borchard the holder, John Sandy the snapper.
Breeze freshens a little now.
High snap, Borchard puts it down, Baselli kicks it on the way, and good. Boy, good with about 15 to spare. That was an excellent kick by Mike Baselli. So we have timeout on the field, 8 minutes to go first quarter at San Jose State 7, Stanford 3 on the All right, Baselli to kick off, 7-3 here, San Jose State the lead. 8 minutes to go first quarter, Baselli drives one, this one got a little better leg into it. LeBlanc will field it at the goal line, far side. Up to the 10, cuts back middle 15, 20, and then brought down at the 21-yard line, and that's a much better job by Baselli, kicking the ball deep and giving his cover team a chance to do just that, cover the kick, and the defense now gets a little better break. Spartans start at their 21.
Also in on the tackle, number 51, Matt Friedrichs.
Emery Brock, Matt Friedrichs in on the hit. So Chris Kisteller, the senior, did not play in the game here against the Cardinal last year. Brian Vai was the quarterback. Kisteller took over later in the year. Has four wide receivers, battle the running back, gets the handoff left side, cuts back the middle and drives ahead. Now to the 26-yard line. I'll tell you what's going on, Murph, in this first quarter that's got to be of some concern to Stanford. San Jose State's winning the line battle at both on both sides of the ball.
Yeah, that's right down below us. He's number 21.
Three wide receivers right now for Spartans on second and five. Handoff, this time battles hit in the backfield for a loss. Cardinal ready for that call. Stockbauer got through. And he was the first guy to hit battle. But what's happened early on in the game is that the offensive line of the Spartans is getting a little push. Battle is the setback. There's a wing back to the right. That's the tight end Brewer into block. Kisteller back to throw, fires near side. Open man, caught by Pulley for a first down at the 44.
John.
And it's a first down Spartans at their own 44. Now Kisteller back to throw. Quick one to the near side. Pulley, defensive back slip. Pulley has a 50, goes by Johnson, 40, and all the way down to the 30. And oh, that was a play that Chris Johnson, the senior defensive back, will wince when he sees on film. He slipped and fell as Steve Pulley caught the ball. And Johnson recovered, came racing up to try to make a tackle, and Pulley ran right by him.
Yeah, he slipped in response to a little fake. And if it had not been for Steen, the play would have gone for more. Steen caught him from the backside, and Spartans moving the ball with little effort here.
They'll mark it at the Stanford 29-yard line. First down, Pulley's caught five already for 76 yards. Now back to throw, Kisteller. Fakes, now fires one near side. Caught by Pulley. Leaping grab between two Stanford defenders and out of bounds at the 13-yard line. And right now, Pulley is doing to Stanford what Troy Walters has done to other teams this year.
Chris Johnson, number 29, is just having all kinds of trouble out there. Same two receivers. We called about that bracket just a little bit ago. Williams on the underside. It was Johnson trying for the interception. Didn't get there quickly enough. Spartan passing game making it look very easy.
First down, the Stanford 13-yard line. The Spartans lead it 7-3. One setback is battle. Kisteller hands on a delay to battle, hit the line, got nothing. May have lost a yard, in fact. Well, the Cardinals starting to stand up that running play a little bit better. Willie Howard made the hit.
Yeah, you're not going to move Howard very often. And if you do try to move him, you'll probably move him in the wrong direction. They're trying to keep Stanford defense honest by showing the running game. This is the same kind of football that Stanford was forced to play last year. Just show the running game, but then rely, of course, on the passing game. That's what the Spartans will do all afternoon today.
All right, second down, San Jose State and 11 at the Stanford 14. Another handoff to battle, hit the middle, goes to the 12, and that's it.
That was the same play as the touchdown last time around, Ted.
He's back in there as the Spartans spread the field. Five wide receivers, third down at the Stanford 12.
Johnson has Pulley on the left side.
Kisteller changed the play from the shotgun. He's going to run the ball up the middle. He's to the 10. He's to the 5. And he's brought down at the 3. Very close to a first down.
He'd like to call it a draw, but it wasn't a draw. He just ran it right out. Kind of a Ortiz Jenkins play. That's what Jenkins at Arizona likes to do. They get in kind of a short punt formation. They snap the ball to him, and he just reads cross-blocking up front. And Stanford's so busy in pass defense, a lot of people have their backs turned in pass coverage, and they've got that quarterback with the ball running right behind him.
All right,
the ball is marked
at the
fourth down play for the Spartans. Fourth and one at Stanford's four-yard line. Lone back is Morton in the game for the first time. Costeller turns, he's going to run an option, pitch to Morton near side. He's going to turn the corner and dive in for a touchdown.
That's his first play as a Spartan. They run the option to the left side, catch Stanford one man short, and Morton dives in, landed right in the bottom half of the S where it spells Stanford as they're moving from our right to our left toward the closed end of the stadium, and the Spartans have made it look far too easy, and we've said that before, but it's about all we can think of now as we are looking at 13-3 Spartans in the early stages of this game, and Dave Baldwin has really done himself a coaching job up to this point.
All right, Morgan, the left-footed kicker in for the extra point. It is up and good, so we have a timeout, 4:29 to go first quarter, 14-3 now San Jose State. 13-3 San Jose State. Tim Morgan to kick it off of the Spartans. And he boots the ball to the far side of the field, short 20-yard line, fielded there, up the far side of the 30, breaking through down the far side of the 40, cutting back to midfield is Pitts, and Durrani Pitts is down to the 47-yard line of San Jose State. So the Cardinal taking great advantage of short kickoffs and give Stanford credit. They were obviously ready for the fact that Morgan kicks short and to the sides, and Stanford has a different alignment out there. Murphy, it's worked for him.
You know, Ted, this is like, you know, you cover the U.S. National Open Tennis Tournament every year. This is like a tennis match, and you're behind in your serve. I mean, it looks like San Jose is going to score, and Stanford has to outscore San Jose, and they're a serve down. They've got to be coming back here offensively.
Here's Borchardt now with Carter leaving the backfield in motion right. Borchardt back to throw. In the pocket, fires far side, caught by Dave Davis. Wrapped up right away, though. Good tackle by the Spartan secondary. 41-yard line. 6-yard pickup on the pass. DeRay Lewis making the tackle for the Spartan secondary.
I'm not sure that Borchardt, Ted, isn't going to have to throw for something like 400 yards today for Stanford to win if this Stanford defense can't put a dent in that San Jose offense. I think Borchardt is going to have a really big day.
Well, this is a San Jose defense that gave up 767 yards to Colorado.
They got over 500 themselves.
There's a pitch to Carter, sweeping right. Carter to the 40, driving, but he didn't get a first down. Carter did not get the first down. He, for progress, got stopped pretty quickly there by the Spartan defense, and he's going to be about 2 yards short, 39-yard line, and it's going to be third down and two. San Jose State just went 79 yards on 9 plays to score, and the big thing the Spartans have done, they've converted 2 fourth down plays in this first quarter. Now Stanford has a third down they need to convert, third and two. Walters and Davis are both left. Carter the back, Borchardt back to throw. Joe steps up, looking to run, trying to get outside. Can he turn the corner? He is to the first down marker, and more down the far side. All the way down inside the 25 and down to the 20-yard line.
That big guy can run. He's got very deceptive speed and not so deceptive power. And I don't say that critically. I mean, he looks powerful and he runs fast. And if you don't believe that, you weren't here last week or you didn't see him in that North Carolina game last year. This big guy can move.
19-yard run, so Stanford has first down at the Spartan 20. Now trip set, 3 wide receivers right. Davis, Pitts, and Walters. Davis and Walters both line up 2 yards behind the line, though. Lone back, Coy Wire gets the handoff. Wire up the middle, driving, and he's about to the 17, near the 16, almost stripped of the ball. Had to be careful there, because now a flag comes in. The Spartans stood up Coy Wire, and then they were trying to strip the ball from him.
Boy, that was a late flag, Ted.
Yeah, that's an that's a personal foul or unsportsmanlike conduct flag. I think that may go against San Jose State. So play was stopped.
5 yards face mask on the defense. 5 yards marked from the end of the run. Field first down.
The 11-yard line. Borchardt hands off Wire, trying to turn outside. Cuts back at the 10 and is down to the 9. couldn't get outside to turn that corner. Floyd Johnson on the tackle for San Jose State. It was first down and one because of the run and the penalty. Joe. So that's going to be enough to gain another first down, make it first and goal.
Joe Fairchild was trying to throw the block. You folks who are listening and watching here in the stadium saw Joe, number 67, out there trying to make that one block that could have sprung Coy into the end zone, but they just couldn't get their alignment right.
Now Walters left, Pitts right. Eyes set behind Borchardt, first and goal at the 9. Borchardt turns. He's going to play fake. Roll right, but he's in trouble. Steps back around one man. Now tries to keep the ball. Runs, breaks a tackle, and gets all the way down inside the 5. Second and goal at the 3. Ball near side. Eyes set behind Borchardt again. Uso, the only wide receiver. Borchardt turns, gives to Carter. Carter trying to get outside. Got hit, knocked down. Great tackle. He lost a yard as Doray Lewis came up the knife down low. Got Carter down by the ankles and upended him, and Kerry Carter lost a yard. It'll be third and goal at the 4.
Yeah, they were trying to seal that left side, but they couldn't seal Lewis. Lewis got outside the seal that time, and Carter was going to try to outrun him to the corner of the end zone on the left side. He wasn't able to do that. Lewis closed in on him. That was a nice defensive play.
Davis left, Walters right, pro set, Moore and Carter behind Borchardt. Third and goal, 4-yard line. Joe back looking, lobbing to the corner of the end zone, off the hands, incomplete. Dave Davis made a leap, trying to pull it down with Deray Lewis right there on him. And now Stanford has a call to make on 4th and goal at the 4. They're going to send Mike Baselli on the field, and that's it. Make the kick here, 21 yards, far hash. Borchardt holding. And Baselli kicking, and it is good. So we have 16 seconds to go, first quarter. Timeout, 14-6 now, San Jose State. Well, Murph, right now the story is the San Jose State defense has held Stanford to just 65 yards of offense here in the first quarter.
Well, yeah, that's the surprising part of this, the early stage of this game, certainly.
Now Baselli kicks the ball in the end zone. Two receivers wrestle for it. Julian comes out with it and gets hit shy of the 15-yard line. Spartans made a mistake there, and they paid for it as Byron Glaspie of the Cardinal made a great hit.
And very successful with this offense.
Steller back to throw, looking far side. Now going to heat the ball, going to take it down and run it. Gets up to the 19 before Stockbauer brings him down on the final play of the first quarter. And the first quarter belongs to San Jose State. And after one quarter, it is the Spartans 14, Stanford 6 on the Stanford Football Radio Network. 14-6 San Jose State as we start the second quarter here on a bright sunny day at Stanford Stadium. It's beautiful weather. The Cardinal are off next week, and then Oregon State is here for the last home game where you're really going to be sure you can get a ticket, quite frankly.
Talk about surprises.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me about Oregon State, of course.
They'll get a test today.
They're in action today.
At USC. All right, San Jose State second down and a long 5 just shy of their own 20-yard line. 4 wide receivers in there. And I believe Morton is the tailback. Costeller turns, gives the ball to Morton on a draw. And he's hit behind the line and dropped by Sharkestein. There's also a flag down. Good play by Sharkestein hitting Darian Morton. And that is against San Jose State, a holding penalty. So the Cardinal may take that, although the play was dropped for no gain. Half the distance to the goal might be an enticing penalty to accept here.
Here's Chuck McFerrin.
Holding on the offense. Half the distance to the goal. Still second down.
So they'll mark that ball back. And it'll be just shy of the 10-yard line, so this backs up San Jose State. They'll get second down over again. They now need almost 15 for a first.
Well, they're making yards so easily, Ted, that I think you pretty much have to take any defensive penalty that is called, especially at that end of the field, and then try to defend as best you can.
All right, Spartans now with 4 wide receivers. Morton, the tailback. Green goes in motion right to left. Costeller back to throw. Standing there, fires a slant pass, and it's dropped.
Oh.
Nears by himself at the 15-yard line. Dropped the ball. Kenny Nears. Frank Primus was in the path of that pass, and Primus went for an interception, yeah. missed it, and if Nears had held that ball, he would have had a good game.
But his coverage responsibility was on the outside receiver. They just simply lost Nears, Ted, and I didn't want to jump in there, but Stanford had two men trying to cover three, and Nears was wide open. Mm. He just simply dropped that ball. He was the man in motion, and they never covered him.
So now it's third down, 15, just shy of the 10-yard line. Kesteller back to throw. Blitz from Primus. Throws one long, near side, down the sideline, and it is out of bounds. It was caught by Dante Scarborough, but ruled out of bounds. Ryan Fernandez on the coverage. That ball was just a big old dirigible floating down the near side. But Fernandez never saw the ball coming. Scarborough did and made a leaping catch, but he fell out of bounds without getting a foot down in.
Yeah, and if the ball had been in, I think it would have been complete. Brian Taylor had underneath coverage. Fernandez on the backside. And that ball was a looping kind of a throw. You're just asking for an interception, but I think that one would have been complete if it were just to the left about a yard and a half.
Now the punt blocked by Stanford. The punt blocked by Stanford and recovered. It's going to be a safety because the ball hit the upright.
I think it was Jason Willick.
The punt by Morgan was blocked by Stanford, easily blocked right up the middle, and the ball caromed off the man who blocked it, and it hit the upright. Bounced back in the end zone where Stanford fell on it, but of course hitting the upright automatically makes it a dead ball, and it is a safety.
The block hit the upright, killed the ball, made it dead out of bounds. Safety.
So Stanford gets two more on special teams, and they'll get the ball back with a timeout on the field. It's San Jose State 14, Stanford 8. I believe out of Carlsbad, California, a reserve defensive back, a sophomore, the man that came right up the middle to block that punt for the safety. Now the free kick, well done, drives Walters back to the 19, up the near side, 25, 30. Runs into his own man at the 35, blocking, and then falls at the right there at the 35-yard line. So it is now 14-8. In favor of San Jose State, less than a minute gone by in the second quarter.
And Stanford has not yet scored a touchdown, but this may have turned the game around just a bit.
Just in the third quarter, it's UCLA.
Stanford,
Arizona State 7,
has had great field position to operate with so far in the first half. They've had the field position battle won big time, but San Jose State has converted two fourth down plays in the first quarter that helped them score touchdowns. Stanford could not convert on third down plays and had to settle for field goals. Here's Borchard now turning, running a delay handoff, play fake. Back in the pocket, firing deep down the near side for Walters. Got it, Walters has it. Great fingertip catch all the way down to the 30-yard line of San Jose State. Another outstanding catch by Walters.
And DeRay Lewis with the coverage that time, but he was just beaten, but only by a step and a half that time by Walters. And Borchard threw a perfect strike, Ted, right on the tips of his fingers that time. And Troy Walters, if he were a quarter of an inch, he's a small man as it is. If he were any smaller than that, he wouldn't have caught that one. But he is remarkable. He just ran right under the ball. And I think that we've often said he's got that extra little bit of speed when he needs to ignite under the ball.
Notre Dame 34, Oklahoma 30.
Troy Walters the football as he has just broken the all-time Pac-10 record for receiving yardage. He's breaking so many records this year, you really need a book just to keep Troy Walters' records straight.
They ought to go right back to him. That's like Joe to do that. He's the inside receiver in the slot on the right side now.
First down, they're going to run a reverse. Wire hands it off to Walters, coming back near side with blocking. 30, 25, 20, 15, and he's run out of bounds. And then tackled out of bounds, which could well be a flag.
Yeah, they did.
He was tackled more than 5 yards out of bounds at the 12-yard line. So they did come back to him, but this time ran a reverse with a handoff to Coy Wire first. And then they reversed, coming back to the near side to Walters.
And he's amazing, Ted. You remember last week, the two passes that went for a total of 80 yards to him, and you think that he'd get a little tired running as he might have on that last play, but they come right back to him and he's always ready to go.
And Walter's still in the game, coming to the near side.
Single Pitts, coverage too.
Pitts and Davis far side, Wire the back, 13-yard line, Borchard back, looking, now throwing to the end zone. He way overthrew a man in double coverage. He threw that ball away.
The lead, if they could get in and get a touchdown, they still haven't put a touchdown on the board. They've got 8 points, but no touchdown.
Second down and 10 from the state 13. Borchard rolling right, throwing on the run. Walters caught it in the flat. 10, 5, out of bounds, right at the marker. Yeah, I believe he got the first down at the 2-yard line, being run out of bounds there by DeRay Lewis. But Walter's starting to run free a little bit now, and the Cardinal finding him. And now Stanford left first and goal at the San Jose State 2.
Yeah, it looked like Troy was going to get in that time, but you know what DeRay Lewis did? He took the angle of pursuit that time. Instead of trying to chase Walters down from the backside, he cut off the angle, and in doing so prevented the touchdown. The ball's just outside the 2.
Now Coy Wire and Emery Brock, the backs. Everybody in tight, no wide receivers in the game. Borcher turns, going to give the ball to Wire, blocking right side. He's to the goal line and in. Touchdown, Stanford. Coy Wire went in, and Stanford went to power football there. 3 tight ends. And they take it in. Wire does on a 2-yard run.
Yeah, all it has to do is break the plane. Well, that's what he did. And then they broke the ball loose from him, but of little note now as Baselli will try the extra point.
All right, Baselli to kick out of Borchard's hole. And the kick by Baselli is good, so we have timeout with 13:29 to go first half, and Stanford turning the game around, really, Murph, with a block punt for a safety, then take the free kick down for a touchdown, and the Cardinal now lead it 15-14 on the Stanford Football Radio Network.
Gee, Bill, do you really think this bullhorn thing is a good idea?
Look, they hired...
Well, Murph, if you think back, a very big play by Stanford when they accepted that holding penalty. Back,
yeah.
San Jose State up, forced them to punt out of the end zone. That really turned things around.
Yeah, it sure did. And we have Walters now with 3 catches for 69 yards, and we have a lot further to go in this game. And he'll probably at least double that, maybe triple it.
Well, I'm telling you right now, 40 points is going to be needed to win this. Baselli,
no doubt,
kicks it short. Julian will field it far side. Dropped the ball! 13-yard line, then picked it up and got tackled right there, and he barely did recover that ball.
Boy, Hodari was flying from the right side. He came down right in front of the Stanford bench along that right sideline, then turned left. And he almost got there in time so that there would have been a struggle for the ball.
All right, San Jose State now trailing in the game for the first time. 15-14 Cardinal, 4 wide receivers. First down at their 13. Kesteller handing off in the line. Morton up the mid, breaks through 20, 25, and is a first down as Darian Morton ran right over the right side of the offensive line and takes it out to the 27-yard line.
Morton went to Chabot. He was an outstanding running back at Chabot. And no surprise, really, if you look at his record at Chabot, what he is capable of doing.
Only 5'7", 175 from Vacaville, and just got eligible. And they need him with Deontay Whitaker not playing. Kesteller back to throw, fires down the far side. He threw it low, and it's incomplete. Oh, he had an open man racing down the far side. It was Pulley who had run by Brian Taylor. But Kesteller did not throw that ball well. And fortunately for the Cardinal, he didn't throw well. It fell incomplete.
Yeah, Taylor had been beaten on the play. He took the inside route. And they were going to have real trouble with an accurate throw that time. 3 wide receivers again.
Second down and 10. Spartans at their own 27. Stanford now showing a 5-man front. And Kesteller back, lobs the screen over the middle of the tight end Brewer. Wide open 30, 35. Hurdles a tackler as he crosses the 40. Then he dropped the ball. And let's see, they're going to say still San Jose State ball. They're going to rule that Brewer hit the ground. I'm not sure if they ruled that a fumble or not, but the ball belongs to the Spartans at the 45-yard line. I think they ruled Brewer down.
Pretty good play, actually, a forward fumble. And he fumbled it directly end over end to Pulley for what would have been an extra 3 or 4 yards.
Well, you're right. It was a fumble. Now that I see a replay, it was definitely a fumble, and it bounced right into the hands of Pulley. All right, the Spartans now moved it out to their own 45 with a first down. Morton comes out of the backfield in motion right. Kesteller throws a quick screen to Pulley. He's going to throw the ball. He's looking for the quarterback, but he'll get sacked.
Yeah, it was definitely a lateral, Ted.
I think they were going to throw the ball back to Kesteller, the quarterback, Murph, but Real Johnson stayed with Kesteller down the far sideline and shut that play down. Then the Cardinal defenders came in and hit Pulley for a loss back to the 36.
Yeah, it was a backward pass. And, of course, what happens there, Ted, and it's a fundamental play, if you throw back to the quarterback, the quarterback is the forgotten man in pass coverage. Once he gets rid of the ball, nobody's paying attention to him. That throw back to him can be effective. Johnson made a good play defensively.
Big credit to him. Loss of 9. Second and 19. Casteller back, fires down the middle, and a leaping try, and the ball is just jarred free from the hands of Green, Sean Green. Brian Taylor got up there and gave a good pop at the 45 of Stanford. That'll be third and 19.
Well, I'll tell you, this is almost like playing 7-on-7 out in the practice field.
You know what this reminds me of, Murph?
Spring.
This is like watching John Tate throw it again.
Yeah.
Jack Elway was coaching and Dave Baldwin was his receivers coach, and Stanford ran this offense.
Oh, yeah. This game's going to take a long time to play.
Third and 19. Casteller under center now pops up, calls timeout. Obviously didn't like the setup. Cardinal lead at 15-14 with 11:47 to play in the first half. Three wide receivers in for the Spartans. Two left and one right. Ball's in the middle of the field. Casteller back to throw, has a lot of time, fires down the middle, and the receiver fell, and the ball falls incomplete beyond Pulley at the Stanford 38-yard line.
I don't know what happened to Pulley. Stanford was in a zone that time, and Primus had deep coverage out of that zone, and Pulley just fell down. Looked like he might have tripped over the 40-yard line.
All right, let's see how the Cardinal come on this punt here. Colin Branch, who blocked the one for the safety, lines up right over the snapper, and that's where he came. Branch came right up the middle on the last punt and smothered it. Morgan standing at his 21, waits the snap, gets it. This time there's good blocking, and Morgan boots it. Walters will let it. He's going to catch it on the run and almost dropped it. Ooh, and he caught it on a short 24-yard line. That's where Stanford.
Very rapidly. He did a good job catching up with it.
First down, 24-yard line. Borchard back to throw with time. Fires over the middle. Pitts has it 30. 35, first down out to the 38-yard line. Durrani Pitts, who grabbed a couple early, got his hands on that one and runs it up for a first down. Interesting as well on the last series for Stanford. When the Cardinals scored the touchdown, it was Coy Wire that was used in the short yard. Kerry Carter didn't run real well last week and hasn't run well in the first quarter today.
The pattern has been the last couple of weeks to play Carter the first quarter and Wire in the second quarter, and they followed that today.
Now Borchardt with three wide receivers left, turns, gives to Carter. Carter hits the left side, gets to the 40, and that's about it. Maybe the 41. Stanford today does not have their right tackle, Greg Schindler, playing. Ben Garrison is in there now. Also, Paul Weinacht, who's from Philadelphia, a sophomore, playing for the first time, has had some time at right tackle.
Get back to that tennis parlance, that blocked punt and resulting touchdown put Stanford back on serve. They could go a serve up now if they could score and really maybe take control of the game.
Second and 7, Borchardt back with a play fake. Has some time, now fires long, far side. Walters just couldn't hang on. Ball was just beyond his fingertips at the 34-yard line of San Jose State. Let's pause now 10 seconds for station. And it will be Borchardt sending Pitts and Davis right. Walters left, Carter the setback on third down and almost 7. And now timeout, Stanford.
In the top 25.
All right, here's the third down play for Stanford. Davis in motion to the right. Third down and 6. Borchardt back to throw. A blitz coming. It's picked up. He fires the pass. Walters has it across midfield. First down to the Stanford, or rather to the San Jose State 46. And I'll tell you, Murph, if Stanford can protect, which they did there, they picked up that blitz, gave Borchardt enough time. He said, I don't know if there are many teams in the country that can cover Stanford's receivers.
Well, Borchardt, of course, is an outfielder and a switch hitter with power. I'm not so sure he couldn't be a pitcher. He's got a great throwing arm and certainly throw a football.
First down at the Spartans 46. Pitts right, Walters left. Walters wide side of the field.
Single
against,
coverage.
Yeah, against DeRay Lewis. I formation, play fake. Borchardt back, looking Walters. Deep Walters, down the near side. He's out there and it's incomplete, but it's interference as DeRay Lewis is going to be called, and a good call it is, for face guarding.
Yeah, he never turned around.
He face guarded and then he bumped. Walters was going to catch that ball. The only negative on that play from the Stanford side was Borchardt underthrew him
a little bit.
Pass interference on the defense, 15 yards from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
I'm not sure that ball didn't hit DeRay Lewis right in the head. I think it bounced off his helmet, and his helmet simultaneously, I think, made contact with Troy Walters' face mask, thereby the call. And that's what Troy Walters, sometimes the only defense you have against Troy Walters is pass interference.
First down, 31-yard line of San Jose State, 15-yard penalty there. Carter the setback. Borchard play fakes, rolling right. He's being pressured, steps around a man. Now going to run. Up the middle, 25, 20, 15, 10 to the left side of the 5-yard line. And is there going to be an angry San Jose State defender as Borchard ran a play fake, a naked play fake, rolling to his right, and there was a Spartan defensive lineman right in his face.
Yeah.
And Borchard made the guy miss.
Yeah, he did. As big as he is, he's a little bit nifty too. Kenny Sanchez saved the touchdown. Sanchez forced Borchard to turn it back inside, and they were able to bring him down at the 5. Otherwise, he would have walked into the end zone easily.
Marshall Blount was the man that missed him. Telling you, he's Bobby Douglas all over again.
Yeah, he does remind me of Douglas.
First and goal at the 5-yard line. Ice set behind Borchard, ball near hash. Pitts in motion right to left. Handoff goes to Carter. Trying to get outside right, trying to cut back at the hash mark. Gets to the 3-yard line. And that's it.
Ball was carried by Terry Carter.
Carter turned it inside. They were trying to go outside. He was trying to get that one ceiling block on the linebacker from his fullback, Casey Moore. But good pursuit and good flow by the Spartans turned the play inside, and when Carter turned inside, there was too much pursuit and he couldn't find a crease.
Cardinal now go with the short yardage game. Matt Wright and Russell Stewart and Steve Coughlin, three tight ends. High set behind Borchard, second and goal, 3-yard line. Borchard turns, gonna play fake, look to throw it, lob it in the near side. Oh, it's intercepted! Intercepted! Marshall Blount, the man that got burned two plays ago. I'm sorry, that's James Ditch. James Ditch, the man, a defensive lineman, just threw his hands up in the air and intercepted Borchard's pass intended in the near flat.
And Ditch, number 80. I think the pass was intended for the fullback, Casey Moore. They're using Moore as a DK. Looked like he's blocking on a running play for Carter. And he's on the left side. But that big ditch runs right. Yeah, you might say that Borchard hit the ditch that time.
Ran the ball back to the 15-yard line. Casteller handing off to Morton. He's hit at the line by Real Johnson and dropped there. The ball was smothered. I think Ditch was shocked that he caught the ball. He was thinking he was going to bat it down, and the ball just stuck in those big paws of his, and he stumbled. Had Ditch been able to run, he might have scored on that.
Yeah, nothing but green grass all the way to Mountain View that time.
He kind of stumbled around and I think wanted to make sure he held onto the ball and was finally brought down at the 15-yard line. What a huge turnover there. Second down and 10 at the 15-yard line. 5 wideouts now for the Spartans. Casteller throws that flat pass to LeBlanc on the far side. Chris Johnson, though, wraps him up, and Johnson spins him around. LeBlanc breaks a hit, though. Still going on the far side, and he's all the way out past the 35-yard line. The Spartan 37-yard line, 15-14, Stanford the lead. Casteller back, pump fakes, looking long down to the far side, and a low ball that is caught by Pulley just shy of midfield in front of the Stanford bench.
Boy, that was a good throw by Casteller, Ted. That one had a little mustard on it. I mean, he really put some heat on that one, threw it down. No chance for any defender to get any piece of that. Gain of about 12 or so. Easily for the first down. I'm very impressed with Casteller. He's very accurate.
Well, now Randy Fasani is starting to warm up on the Stanford sideline. Throwing the ball with Husak. Here is a handoff, and Morton hits the line, and Morton gets forward a yard to the 50-yard line.
Are you sure it isn't Husak that's warming up?
Well,
I wonder.
They're throwing with each other.
Yeah.
And all he can say is, of course, they do have one touchdown, but three other times they've been denied two field goals and now a crucial interception from midfield. Casteller back blitzed, fires the ball away, and it's intercepted. Brian Taylor, 30-yard line of Stanford.
That was a free safety blitz. That was Tank Williams. He really got in the face of Casteller in a hurry that time, and he threw in much too much of a hurry and threw the ball directly to Brian Taylor. He could have called for a fair catch. Borchard is 6 of 13 for 101 yards.
Well, Murph, there was a case where Casteller changed the play. He saw the blitz coming, and he tried to throw a ball quickly before he got hit down the far side, but he threw another one of those dirigibles up there. The ball was just spinning end over end, and it was well over the head of the intended receiver and right into Brian Taylor's hands. 30-yard line, first down Stanford. Here's Fasani now into quarterback.
Yep.
Emery Brock and Brian Allen now the runners in a nice set. Fasani play fakes, looking to throw, fires down the near side, a high floater for Dave Davis, and it's incomplete at the 35 of San Jose State. Davis jockeying with DeRay Lewis again.
These quarterbacks come off the bench for Stanford. Borchardt a week ago, Fasani now. They're not afraid to put a little air under the ball, are they?
Well, one thing that we should say, and again, I think we've done a lot of pointing out of the positives of Joe Borchardt, but that interception at the goal line in the previous possession points out one of Todd Husak's strengths. He does not get picked off. And that's something that the Cardinal miss when Husak's not in there. Three receivers left, wide side of the field. Allen, the lone running back, second down and 10. Fasani gives to Allen, counter play up the middle to the 35, and Allen runs well to the 36. So that's a 6-yard pickup. Husak, 106 passes this year, and he's only been intercepted twice.
Yeah.
And last year was even better. Last year, when he had to throw all the time, 447 passes last year, Murph, and Husak only got intercepted 7 times.
Yeah, that's an amazing accomplishment. Most of that is because he's got a very good head on his shoulders for this game.
Now 3rd and 4, 36-yard line of Stanford. Fasani under center, turns, goes back to throw, keeps it back into block, now in trouble, trying to get away. Going to run the ball, trying to get back to the 35-yard line, and that's going to be it. Too many white shirts in the middle of the field, right between the hash marks for San Jose State. And Fasani kept trying to weave his way through all the on-rushing defenders and finally got brought down at the 35 for a loss of 1. So on Fasani's first series, it's 3 and out, Tolpenrud into punt. Only the 2nd punt for Stanford. Walking Bailey is deep. Standing at the Spartan 25, 15-14 Stanford. Here's the punt by Tolpenrud, high. Floater, near side, Bailey signals 25-yard line. Now he's gonna run the ball back. I couldn't tell if he's calling for a fair catch or not. And he runs to the 29 before being brought down. All right, now the Spartans at their own 29-yard line with a 1st down. Morton the back behind Kesteller. 3 receivers left, wide side. Kesteller back, looking, fires the slant pass, caught, 35 to the 40, goes Green out to the 45-yard line. That is Sean Green, a junior, and he runs it out just across the San Jose State 45-yard line.
Can you imagine
quarterbacks?
Who wouldn't want to get on the end of those passes?
1st down, option play, pitch out to Morton, coming near side. He's got a little room to the near sideline, then Brian Taylor runs him out of bounds at midfield. Mark it at the 49. I believe the 49 of, actually the 48 of Stanford. So he got 7 yards on that play, and it will leave San Jose State with a 2nd and 3.
You know, the Spartans have really kind of taken the physical side of football out of this game. This is a finesse kind of game. It's, you know, real, what do they call it now, the old cliche, smash mouth football. There isn't much of that out there today. This is quick stuff.
Kesteller under center, turns and gives the ball to Morton again, right up the middle, and Austin Lee got him. And Austin Lee almost wrenched the ball away. Brought Morton down after a 1-yard gain, and Lee came awfully close to stripping that ball away. So now it's going to be 3rd down and a long 2 for the Spartans at their own, at the Stanford 47-yard line.
He's back out there. He's lined up on the left side. Indicates they're going to run that way. Let's see what happens.
Morton, the only back. 3rd down. Kesteller changing at the line now.
Yeah,
pops up.
Stanford put the extra man over there.
Kesteller goes back, looking for the quick pass, fires near side, caught by Pulley. Brian Taylor drags him down, but it's a 1st down play. Just a little short 3-yard hitch pass. Brian Taylor wrapped him up, and now Brian Taylor appears to be injured on the tackle. It's to the 41-yard line of Stanford.
That's exactly what happened, Ted. They put the tight end in. Brewer went in, that big number 88. He's posted up on the left side, and I'm sure they were going to run that way. That's why the tight end is there. And the quarterback, Kesteller, looks over there, sees Stanford with the extra man as they shifted to strength. And instead of running to the left, they threw to the right.
Well, Taylor appears to be shaken up, but he's still out there. So is Tank Williams. 1st down, San Jose State, Stanford 41. Kesteller stumbles going back, gives on a delay to Morton, breaks up the middle, still running. Near side 30, 25, 20, and down to the 18. Yard line, goes back to throw. Time, now fires to the end zone, and it's incomplete. Ooh, and that was a poorer choice. Frank Primus had Casey LeBlanc covered on a post pattern, and the only thing that saved an interception there was Kesteller threw it over everybody's head.
You know, Morton at Chabot last year ran for almost 1,300 yards. He had an 8.4-yard rushing average, and he scored 15 touchdowns on running plays. That is quite a record, and no one should be surprised at what he's doing here today.
18-yard line, second down and 10 for San Jose State. Now a blitz by Primus. Costello is going to get sacked. Primus coming from the outside. Stockbauer up the middle. And Kent Bear, who has done this a lot this year, Murph, has really gambled on defense, and that pays off, driving the Spartans back to the 27.
Well, he's got to catch them. Ted, he's got to catch them in some kind of a passing situation where it's not that two- or three-step drop and that quick release. And that time, Stockbauer coming up the middle. I think he might have been able to handle Primus on his left side okay, but Stockbauer hit him right in the face, drove him backwards, and this is third and way long.
Third and 19 at the Stanford 27. One setback, three wide receivers in the game. Kesteller back to throw, being flushed out of the pocket. Flag down, floats one out of bounds into the Spartan sideline. But now a flag is thrown, and that's holding.
That is.
And now that's an interesting choice here for Stanford.
Yeah, that's a holding call.
And you can really back San Jose State up here and take them out of field goal range by taking the penalty. You do give them, of course, one more play.
They're almost out of field goal range anyway,
right.
I think. The flag was thrown on Provost, I'm sure, on holding.
But that flag is thrown about 5 yards behind the line, Murphs. That could be about a 15-yard penalty.
Holding on the offense. That penalty is declined. Fourth down.
All right, so Cardinal will leave it at the 27-yard line. So it's been his longest kick this year. He's 3 out of 7. This will be 44 yards for the lead at 2:17 to go in the first half.
Kessler is the holder. Watch out for the fake here.
There's the snap, ball down, kicked by Morgan on the way, and it is good.
They got the lead back.
Stanford gambled and lost. And a penalty there. If they had accepted that penalty, they would have taken the field goal away. And Morgan drilled it from 44 yards, and so San Jose State regains the lead with 2:13 to go in the half, 17-15. Kicks off and he drives this one deep. Walder's going way back into the end zone and he will down it.
It's that breeze again.
So there, I guess with the wind, Morgan able to kick with some leg, and now Stanford will, for the first time, start from its own 20-yard line. Stanford's at good field position in this first half.
San Jose has locked them into 15 here with 2:07 left in the first half.
Eddie Gales now in the game for the first time. He's a slot back standing alongside Borchardt in his shotgun. Borchardt being blitzed, stepping up, running to the near side, brought down from behind. Well, they blitzed from the outside at San Jose State. Samson Sherrod. And he sacked Borchardt. Stanford now.
Timeout, Stanford, their third and final half.
He's going to take the final timeout to try to regroup after the sack with 1:54 to play. Right. Low snap, nicely caught by Borchardt. He stands in, he throws over the middle, caught by Pitts, got room. Far side 25 to the 30, up the sideline 35, 40, and he runs out of bounds all the way out to the 43.
Yeah, and Dave Davis did a great job blocking over there. He added about 8 or 9 yards to that play, Ted.
Hits right.
Yeah, watch Walters with single coverage. May get safety help on the left side.
Well, they've got three receivers left. Wide side of the field. Borchardt from the gun again. Back to throw. Back to throw. Lobbing one to the near side for Davis, and it is incomplete. Davis being covered by Costas as he ran to the near side. That ball floating out there hit Davis in the arm but fell to the ground. Four wideouts in now. Two left, two right. Borchardt from the gun. Steps up. Going to be hit. Going to be hit. Now lost the football. It's bouncing on the ground and it's covered by Stanford. Thankfully at the 40-yard line, Mike McLaughlin fell on the ball as Borchardt that time trying to sneak through the middle and step up through the on-rushing players, dropped the ball.
Kronshagen is hurt. Jeff Kronshagen has taken a knee out there. That doesn't look good.
Kronshagen kneeling at the 38-yard line.
And he didn't just go to a kneeling position. He pretty well fell to a kneeling position.
Pitts and Davis right, Walters and Uso left, shotgun Borchardt standing in, stepping up, hit, goes down. Well, he had enough time. That's really more coverage than anything else. Borchardt enough time. San Jose State must have covered well, and the sack made by Samson Sherrod is second of this series.
Sometimes he wasn't.
No.
He wasn't faking. He was doing it for real.
It was improvisation. All right, here's a snap to Tulpin Roon, and he gets the kick away. It's a high one, nice one. Bailey's calling a fair catch, but backing way up, and he dropped it! It's loose! And a big pileup at the 20-yard line!
I think Stanford's got it. I think the Cardinal has it.
Well, they're going to have to unpile here. Stanford says it's theirs, and what a break if it is.
They had two people there. The Spartans only had one.
Tank Williams was down there. Joaquin Bailey just dropped it on a fair catch. They're still unpiling, and San Jose State has it. Wow. Recovered fumble of his own fair catch, really a muff, not a fumble. A muff at the 19-yard line. 55 seconds to go in the half and no timeouts for San Jose.
Just going through my notes here, and one of the things I jotted down is one of the keys to the game is Spartan defense. We haven't talked much about that, but that Spartan defense has done a whale of a job here in this first half.
All right, first down, 19-yard line, three wide receivers right for Castella, runs a draw play to Morton, breaks past the line to the 20, then wrapped up and dropped to the 23. So that'll, of course, not allow San Jose to stop the clock. So a little gamble there by Dave Baldwin that didn't work. Clock running now at down to 38 seconds, and the Spartans now appear to be content. They're not going to hurry up. They're going to take this lead into the locker room.
Well, I would.
Yep, in fact, they send Green back as a safety man in case there's a fumble, and Casteller will take the snap and take a knee.
And that'll be the first half. We're going to talk to John Ralston, the old coach, at halftime. John is one of those folks that's been on both sides of this 100th year of this relationship, Ted. 100 years. They played in 1900, these two teams. In fact, they had so much fun in 1900, they played twice.
Well, here for the second straight season. Last year, of course, it was the opening game. 2 years from now, the teams will meet in San Jose as Morgan kicks it off. High and short, far side, and out of bounds. Ryan Wells went to the sideline, let it go, and Stanford will come out and start at their 35. The Spartans have had, or rather the Cardinal today, have had just outstanding field position. Made life a lot easier for the offense, but one thing that you find out, I mean, this is the first start for Joe Borchardt. It's the first, you know, real substantial time when the Cardinal said, okay, win the game for us, and it is a whole different scenario.
Well, this possession is of prime importance now.
Lone back is Carter. Davis left, Walters right, handoff to Carter, and he's hit behind the line and goes down. And Carter ran into his own man, and Mike McLaughlin.
Yeah, he got hurt.
I think Carter kicked him. Carter trying to cut back from right to left, bumped right into McLaughlin. And McLaughlin tackled him at 33 for a 2-yard loss.
Yeah, I think
a second down, Borchardt back to throw, being pressured. Now screens it on the right side to Moore, and Moore to the far sideline is brought down as Wynack, the young offensive lineman, could not get a block on the San Jose State defender. Saying how to get a little emotion going. It's a rather uninspiring crowd, and the Cardinal don't look to be as excited.
Very quiet
as they've
here.
Been. Yeah, Borchardt play fake, back to throw, stepping up, wings one in the flat. Walters has it 40, cuts up the middle, 45, got the first down.
When in doubt, throw it to Walters.
Yeah. Boy, isn't that true? And doesn't he continue to be the big play guy?
Oh, yeah.
His fifth catch today, that's good for 12 yards, so he now has 93 passing or receiving yards, and the Cardinal have a first down.
In fact, maybe your offense at this point, you're having so much difficulty, is just keep throwing it to Walters. You know, don't get too fancy.
All right, first down now. Stanford at their own 46 from the I set. Borchardt delay handoff to Carter coming to the near side. Cuts back nicely to the 50. Breaks a hit 45 down to the 40, but a flag goes down. A late flag behind the play, and that may wipe out an awfully good run by Kerry Carter that took it inside the 40 of San Jose State, and they're going to call a hold. And that was on the Stanford offensive line well behind the play.
Yeah, that was just a little shaft of daylight that the Cardinal has a chance to see in the running game, and then that gets called back, so.
Holding on the offense, 10-yard penalty, still first down.
For 37-yard line, first down again. Borchardt play fake, standing in the pocket with time, fires over the middle, caught by Pitts at the 50 to the 46-yard line of San Jose State, where DeRay Lewis brings him down. That's about 2 yards shy of a first down.
The ball up in the eye.
Spartan 46-yard line, second down and two. Under center, Borchardt hands the ball to Moore straight ahead. Nothing there, not a thing. Ran right into a wall of white at the line of scrimmage. half, 45-yard line of San Jose. Borchardt turns, going to run an option, pitch the ball to Carter. He's not going to get there. Carter hit at the line of scrimmage and brought down. He fumbled the ball, but the ground caused it. And now Tyrone Willingham has to make a big call here. The ball is marked at the 45 of San Jose State. And this is
one affirmative, positive thing that gives you some life. And wasn't it in this kind of a situation where Tolpenrud ran it last week?
He won't run it here. He's going to try to pooch punt it. Kicks it up high to the middle of the field. Walking Bailey, fair catch, 17-yard line. So that's only a 28-yard punt. And about 2.5 yards to go, and on two plays could not get those 2.5 yards. So now the Spartans have first down at their 17-yard line. Under center, Casteller. Battle is in the game, and now flags go down as there was some shifting around by the Spartans. I don't think Stanford did anything there. I think San Jose State lined up inappropriately.
Dead ball, false start on the offense. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
All right, first and 15 for the Spartans at their own 12-yard line. Four wide receivers, three left, one right. And Casteller runs a draw play, and it's hit by Sharkus Steen. The runner battle drives Steen forward, actually, to gain about a yard or two, but Sharkus Steen stood that play up right away.
Spartans only punted twice in the first half. Of course, they did give up the safety, and they had a ball intercepted. But they did a pretty good job of moving it, too. A touchdown by Battle, touchdown by Morton. 44-yard field goal by Tim Morgan.
That adds sixth DB. As Casteller goes back, throws one of the flat, incomplete. Ryan Fernandez very close, and on the San Jose State sideline, they think too close to Sean Green, the intended receiver, on just a little curl pattern at the 15-yard line.
Stanford got good pressure on Casteller that time. Real Johnson, number 97 from the right side, particularly got in there.
Oh, I can see more of Willie Howard and Tim Smith, and they're the guys that Tyrone looks to as the leaders. Willie Howard running around trying to get the people cheering.
Well,
hey, let's go, make some noise in here.
Somebody's got to get them going.
Third down, 13. Spartans at their own 14.
Need to get themselves going, too, a little.
And back to throw, Casteller being blitzed, wrapped up, brought down, 6-yard line. It was Tim Smith who got in first. Primus follows.
Yeah, Primus out of the secondary comes in there. And they finally made it work and moved the Spartans way back that time. Ball's on the 6-yard line now for a punting situation.
Well, the last time the Spartans punted from their end zone, Stanford blocked it. Morgan in the end zone, he's standing about 8 yards deep. Troy Walters is at the Spartan 45. So Stanford should get great field position out of this punt. There's a high snap, Morgan jumps, pulls it down, gets the kick away. It's gonna be caught by Walters at the 44, comes up the middle to the 40, stumbles to the outside and is wrapped up and brought down. But still great field position for Stanford. 40-yard line, 17-15, San Jose State. Borchard runs a play fake, dropping back, stepping up now, looking, play fake, gonna run to the right side and gets to the 36. Husinich, who just made the special teams play, made the tackle there on Borchard, but Borchard gains 4 yards. Second down, 36-yard line. Walters now in motion to the wide side of the field.
Man coverage.
And they're gonna run a delay handoff to Carter, coming to the far side of the field. He slips and goes down. Carter tried to cut to get around the one defender that was there, Josh Perry, and Carter slipped and fell. And he's gonna have no gain. Kerry Carter just does not look good today, and I don't know if he's hurt or whatever. He just does not look.
Came in motion, you saw the defender come with him. That indicates man coverage.
Coy Wire now leaving the backfield. Nobody behind Borchard.
Zone
and
now.
Finally whistles and
timeout.
I think, I don't think Borchard called that. I'm not sure who did.
Boy, I don't know. They're
Borchard was under center to take a snap and somebody called a timeout there.
Yeah.
San Jose State 36, Spartans ahead 17-15, third quarter. Coy Wire leaving the backfield. Borchard under center.
Eight
two tight ends in the game. Here comes a big blitz. Quick pass in the middle is dropped by Walters. Well, San Jose State blitzed. Stanford had a play to beat it, that quick screen over the middle of Walters, but Troy dropped it.
I didn't mean to.
San Jose State, 36, trying to kill this one, and a fair catch by Bailey at the 15-yard line. So Stanford trying to play this for field position, and a 59 to go in the third quarter. 17-15, San Jose State. Casteller comes under center, five wideouts, nobody behind him, four-man rush, quick pass over the middle, low and incomplete. Sean Green, 20-yard line, the intended man. Tank Williams, the cover.
Yeah, Green was an open receiver that time, too. That we haven't seen Kosteller throw many bad balls. That was down ahead of him and into the turf that time. That one had no chance at all.
Kosteller was 13 out of 26 at the half. Now 13 out of 28.
Maybe the Stanford defense has to score. Maybe that's the way to do it.
All right, four down again. This time a back in the game. Three-step drop. Kosteller fires to the near side. Caught by Bailey. Wrapped up by Primus. Drives forward, though, and gets close to, but still short of the first down. He's out to the 24-yard line. Third down, and it's nearly 3 yards. Lone back is Morton. Kosteller going to run an option. Coming to the near side. Ducks up, and I think he got there. He kept it himself. Austin Lee made the hit, and Kosteller is right at the stick. The Spartans say he got it.
I think so.
And the officials agree. First down, San Jose. 23 seconds to go. Arizona State has scored a touchdown.
Oh, my.
Taking the lead.
Oh, boy.
28-27. Kosteller on first down. Going to run a reverse handoff here to LeBlanc. Coming to the near side. Got around Tim Smith. Turns it up to the 30. To the 35 and out of bounds.
Boy, I'll tell you, that LeBlanc is a gamer.
2-3 now. Second and two Spartans at their own 35-yard line. San Jose State ahead 17-15. Play fake, rolling right. Kosteller throwing on the run, caught by the tight end Brewer, out of bounds. Just a couple of yards, but enough for a first down as Stockbauer made the Stanford tackle right into the Spartan bench at the 39-yard line.
That linebacker always has to be alert for that tight end. That was another weak side effort. They put the tight end on the near side, but they lined up strong to the left and isolated the tight end. Stockbauer stayed right with him. Good coverage, but a beautiful throw by Kosteller for the completion.
First down, Spartans at their own 39. Now Kosteller going to hand the ball up the middle. Big hole, Morton, 40, 45. Breaks in the free at the 50, and then Smith drags him down at the Stanford 45, and that was a magnificent play by San Jose State. They faked that same little reverse handoff to LeBlanc that's worked so well and sucked in the entire Stanford defense. Johnson has left the field. First down, Stanford 45-yard line. It's a big, big stop now that the Cardinal defense needs to make. Kosteller changing up at the line. Stanford rushing, back to throw, long pass near side. Pulley, fingertip catch. Beautiful catch out of bounds at the 16.
Williams, the free safety, was in the zip code, but trailing the play. And a magnificent throw that time. A fabulous catch going out of bounds. And that is some receiver. That young man is the leading receiver for this team, and Pulley can really play football.
Well, Steve Pulley played very little for San Jose State last year. He had a hamstring injury and got buried on the depth chart, but he has come back to catch 9 passes today. And that's a huge one as he beat Ryan Fernandez in man coverage. Stanford was blitzing on the play, and San Jose State beat him on that blitz. Now Kosteller comes up to the line, takes timeout. So will we, with 5:58 to go, third quarter. San Jose State ahead 17-15 on the Kosteller under center, Morton the tailback. Now they run that fake handoff to LeBlanc, rolling to his right. Kosteller looking, fires to the middle of the end zone. It's a leaping try and incomplete. Broken up. I think Chris Johnson nicely got a hand on that pass. Kenny Nears made a leap in the back of the end zone to try to catch it.
Tim Smith was also there, and I think Kosteller was very sure that time, Ted, that he was not going to underthrow that ball. If that ball was going to be caught at all, it was going to be caught by his receiver or perhaps batted out of bounds, but not intercepted by Stanford in the end zone for a touchback. Pretty heady play, actually. Second down.
All right, here's Kosteller now bringing him up. Pulley goes wide left all the way out to the far side where Chris Johnson covers.
Single coverage. Johnson the only guy there.
Now they have 3 receivers left, and they're going to run the ball right to Morton. He got hit by Willie Howard and dropped to the 15.
They're spelling one another.
All right, third down and 9 at the 15. 5 wideouts for San Jose State. Kosteller, 3-step drop, throws the quick slant. Caught! Pulley somehow caught it at the 5-yard line and goes in for a touchdown.
Tim Smith, I think, tried for the interception, Ted. In fact, for an instant, I thought that maybe he had made the interception, stepping in front of the receiver, and somehow, we don't have the benefit of a television replay today, but somehow Pulley ended up with that ball, and he's having quite a day for himself. And that is a big touchdown for the Spartans as the strong safety. That was Tim Smith stepping up, looking for the interception, the completion somehow to Pulley, and he took it in untouched for the score.
Murph, there were two defenders between Pulley and the ball. I don't know how it got through both. The extra point is good. Tim Smith was in the passing lane, to use a basketball term, looked like he was going to pick
exactly.
it. And the defender was in front of Pulley, too. I don't know how the football got through both of those men, but it did. A 15-yard touchdown pass, and with the extra point, timeout at 5:05 to go third quarter. It is now San Jose State 24, Stanford 15.
Stanford had to go for 2 3-pointers, you'll remember.
Now Morgan kicking deep. Walters 3-yard line comes up the middle to the 10, to the 15, to the outside he goes, and he can't get free. Breaks a couple of tackles, but finally dragged down at the 21-yard line by San Jose State. There's a long way to go. And the Cardinal offense has just sputtered today. First down at the 21-yard line. Coy Wire the back. Borchard three-step drop. Quick out pass. Dave Davis on the run to the 30. Steps back to the inside. 35 and out to the 38. There's a good first down play. Yeah. Out to the 39, 18 yards.
It's a very easy ball to catch. Davis made a nice move, then took it back inside to get a little extra yardage after the first down. That was a pretty good gainer right there.
Jeff Kronshagen, the senior left tackle for the Cardinal, has not been back in this game since he got hurt earlier.
No, he's got problems with that right knee across the way. I looked at him just a moment ago.
First down from the 39, handoff to Coy Wire up the middle. Wire pushing ahead to the 42, and I think Tyrone Willingham may see a little bit more Coy Wire now as this game goes along. It has not been a good afternoon for Kerry Carter. A wide right, Casey Moore, the fullback in front of Coy Wire. Second down and 7.
Single coverage on Walters.
Now Borchard gonna run a play fake. Drop back being pressured, screen pass right side, but it's jarred free, and the ball's ruled incomplete. Casey Moore was the intended receiver on a screen pass, but there was a defender, Ron Okimi, that just blasted Casey Moore as he tried to catch that ball and knocked it free. Incomplete
yeah.
pass.
He got there 1 split second after the football did, and I don't think Moore had much chance. In fact, if he'd gotten there a bit later, it might have been worse because Moore would have caught it, Ted.
And third today, 2 out of 6, third down and 7. 42-yard line. Borchard goes back. Four-man rush. Pass down the middle. Walters has it 40. Flag down, 35. Goes outside 30. 25, and he's run out of bounds. But there's a flag down. There are two flags down.
It's some kind of pass interference, I'll guarantee you that. It's got to be some kind of offensive or defensive pass interference or holding. It's on the near side of the field, right in front of the Spartan bench, right at the 50-yard line, and the flags were thrown early right in the middle of the play.
Holding on the defense, penalty decline.
Yeah, there it is.
And so a big play there. Borchard to Troy Walters takes the ball to the 25-yard line of San Jose State.
Well, Denny Erickson's done quite a job up there. Here we go.
High set behind Borchard, first down, Spartan 25-yard line. 24-15, San Jose State. And Borchard gonna roll to the wide side of the field, looking to lob one down the near side for Pitts, who got pushed about 4 times and no flag.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Wow, that was blatant. Jamar Julian just kept leaning on Pitts' right shoulder and riding him all the way down the sideline, and there was no flag as the ball fell incomplete.
Sure made a good call on that, Ted. That you saw that all the way.
Well, that looked so blatant, I didn't even watch the ball. I was watching the referee to throw the flag.
Lot, single coverage. They got a little safety in the middle.
Play fake to Brian Allen. Borchard looking deep, throwing down the near side. Walters there, touchdown!
Got to just watch Walters all the time. And the safety tried, but he didn't get there soon enough, Ted. They needed Julian to commit himself faster that time. And Walters, with that just sudden move, took it inside. Remember now, he was in the slot on the left side. He runs it right to the post, right down to the post, and at the 10-yard line, made a sharp break to his left, ran right at the Spartan rooting section, seated to our left. And Borchard delivered a picture-perfect throw. Did not throw it too hard, put a lot of air under it. Troy ran under it for the score.
25-yard touchdown pass, extra point by Baselli is good. So Troy Walters has caught 7 passes today for 151 yards, 37 catches on the year for 766 yards in 5 games, and he's caught 5 touchdown passes. Timeout on the
never miss your game. Come find me.
And you will. Online at gtesuperpages.com. The number one Yellow Pages directory on the internet. Superpages.com. More ideas, more fun. Shop on.
to the 17-yard line before Emery Brock and Adam Scholes, young man we've not seen much of on special teams for the Cardinal, make the tackle. They'll spot it at the 18 for San Jose State.
The 79 yards, including the 25 for the touchdown.
Now the Spartans show shotgun. Kesteller has five wideouts, two left, three right, standing with all kinds of time. Fires over the middle, caught across the 30. No, incomplete the ruling. They're saying that Nears short hopped the ball, Kenny Nears, at the 31-yard line.
Well, that's a real break for the Cardinal because that was a wide open receiver. And Kesteller came up just a little bit short.
He had his with his helmet on, but he's not been back in.
Tim Smith at the line of scrimmage.
First down, or rather second down and 10 from the 18-yard line. Kesteller, zone. Play fake, hands off to LeBlanc. Cuts back up the middle, cutting to the near side. Tripped up from behind, a beautiful tackle by Stockbauer. Just shy of the 20-yard line as LeBlanc ran about 50 yards in the middle of the field to gain two.
Remarkable talent for running against the grain. He just seems to have a sense for that. He went to Bellarmine, played there, and he's just a gamer. He's a kind of a kid you really like to watch.
Now the gun again for the Spartans with five wide receivers on third and eight from their own 20-yard line.
Four-man rush.
Cardinal with six defensive backs. Kesteller being blitzed, fires a near side screen. It's caught but wrapped up. Ryan Fernandez made the great hit on Pulley and drops him at the 21. And there's the first big defensive play that the converted wide receiver from Skyline High, Ryan Fernandez, has a chance to make.
Yeah, Stanford put the extra man in the blitz, too. They had five coming, and that surprised the quarterback when he unloaded. Had an easy completion, but Fernandez took care of the rest of it.
Tarani Pitts now back on this punt. Morgan standing at his five-yard line for San Jose State. Low snap, he fields it, and he punts it. And Durrani Pitts to the near side, lets it hit at the 40. It bounces high and will be a short little San Jose State hop and then down 39-yard line. And he turned a play fake. Borchard looks, quick slant, knocked down at the line. Boy, Borchard's got to be careful of those passes. That ball should have been intercepted.
That was
John Acuna, a linebacker, that ball hit him right in his hands. And Walter's going to go in motion the same way.
Man coverage.
Now a turn, a roll right by Borchard. Roll right, throwing on the run. And that's caught by Pitts.
Oh, what a
play. A great catch with Jamar Julian cutting and diving in front of him right over his right shoulder, trying for the interception. Pitts made a diving catch just across midfield, first down.
I'm surprised that Julian.
56 yards, first down at the San Jose State 49. And now they're going to pitch the ball and sweep near side, Brian Allen. Allen coming out, has got a little room, turns the corner, 45. Flag down, though. And another holding penalty is going to bring that back as Allen got inside the 40-yard line. For the second time, I think they got Wynacht, the young man playing today for the first time. I believe he got called for the hold.
Yeah, he and McLaughlin were blocking in combination that time. They did a good job, maybe too good.
10-yard penalty, still first down.
An offensive line, Stanford 45. Play fake, Borchard rolling right, stepping up, now fires to the far side, and it went right through Walter's hands. Wow. Never see that. Walters had turned out to the sideline right in front of the first down stick at the Stanford bench, and the ball skipped right through.
Right, Walters.
Davis is left. Glaspie now the fullback in front of Brian Allen. Second down and almost 16. Play fake blitz. Borchard in trouble, hit. Ball pops free. Picked up. It's a fumble, and it's going to be a San Jose State touchdown.
Oh, boy.
It's ruled a fumble and picked up and run back by Ron Okimi for a touchdown.
Yep.
Third quarter, and here's Morgan for the extra point. And the kick is good, and another big turnaround. And the San Jose State defense has made more than their share of big plays today.
Challenge, Toyota Tundra. Work or play, every day.
High short kick, run back up the far side, and run back well by Ryan Wells all the way to the 45-yard line. Well, this game right now is completely destroying the football notion that field position is everything. Stanford has dominated field position in this game.
That's right.
And San Jose State leads by 31-22 with 55 seconds to play in the third quarter. Set behind Borchard, Walters left, Davis is right. And a pitch play now, Brian Allen sweeping to the near side, and he's going to get to outside, turn the corner, 50, 45, first down run, I believe. See where they mark him as he's run out in the Spartan bench to the San Jose State 43. That's the same play that Stanford has run twice earlier and been called for holding. No flags this time. And yeah. Brian Allen runs for a first down.
The Stanford team could use somebody coming off the bench and becoming a hero. And maybe Brian Allen is that kind of a player. He ran well against the Bruins last week.
The 43, delay handoff, Allen. Allen cutting to the hash mark to the 40 and down to the 39 of San Jose.
He got about five there.
Side. Second down, six. Davis split left, short side. Orchard going to hand the ball off again to Allen. Cuts back to the 35 in the middle, 30 in the free to the 20. He's gone. What a run. Touchdown, Stanford, Brian Allen.
Brian Allen is the hero coming off the bench. He just ran 39 yards for a touchdown, a quick trap. I think the Spartans that time were looking for the play action pass. They had Troy Walters on the right side.
The longest run of Brian Allen's career and his first touchdown. The sophomore from Ontario, California. 39 yards on the run, and now the extra point by Baselli. And the kick is good. The third quarter ending on the run by Allen. So we will come back with the fourth quarter from Stanford Stadium. It's been the shootout that we thought it would be. San Jose State 31, Stanford 29 on the Stanford football.
7-0, then Stanford came back with a field goal, 7-3. Spartans scored again, Darian Martin from 4 yards out. Stanford came back again with a 21-yard field goal by Baselli, 14-6. So it's been a tough afternoon for the Cardinal. And if they're going to get the lead, they're going to have to start working on it right.
31-29, Spartans lead it. Baselli will kick. LeBlanc and Julien are deep. And Baselli's kick is going to be short. Fielded 7-yard line by Julien. Up the far side to the 15. Trying to bounce to the outside. Got around to the 20. To the 25 and run out of bounds. Finally at the 27-yard line. And now a late flag is thrown. Spartans. And it is a hold on the run back. It's Casteller now with Darian Morton making his Spartan and college debut today as the lone back. Four wide receivers in the game. It's a handoff to Morton. Hits the line, hit by Stockbauer, plows ahead and does gain a few. That's a nice run actually with not much room. Morton plows it out to the 15-yard line. Six now from the San Jose 15. Casteller back, three-step drop, quick pass up the far side, incomplete. They tried to hit Pulley on the run, working Ryan Fernandez, and the ball hit Pulley in the shoulder pads and carried away. Tim Smith was closing in from his safety spot.
Yeah, looking over there, and it was Smith with that upward thrust, batted that ball into the Stanford bench.
Wilmer.
Number two, aren't we? Number 18.
Third down and six at the 15-yard line. Shotgun with five wideouts.
Big
Casteller back from the 6-yard line. Being blitzed, sacked. Mark Stockbauer. Sacks him back at the 5-yard line, and Casteller is slow and has yet to get up.
Yeah, he's still not up. Stockbauer just came like a shot from the left side. He was never touched. Casteller is down and appears to be wounded.
That is the fourth sack by the Cardinal today on a third down play. And Casteller now being looked at by the longtime Spartans trainer, Charlie Miller.
Before Ted.
Now Casteller got up and ran off under his own power. That's a good sign. All right, here's Morgan standing at the back of the end zone. Troy Walters awaiting the punt at the 43 of San Jose State. A snap is there. It's fielded, and Morgan gets it away. It's a low kick. Walters back to the 48, slips and goes down. Walters had to back up to field that punt, and his feet gave way at the San Jose State 48. Pitts in motion right out there with Dave Davis. It's going to be a short side pitch. Coy Wire got a good block by Moore. Runs it up to the 45 and the 44. Now, Coy Wire today, Murph, in his few carries, is running the way Kerry Carter ran earlier the year. He's driving his legs, plowing ahead, and pushing some people.
I think
Allen have been the backs today, and now Allen is the tailback, Moore the fullback, 44-yard line, second down and six. Orchard under center, turns, going to give to Allen on a delay play to the left side. Not much there. Now he scampers outside, got to the line of scrimmage and moves it ahead maybe a yard before he's finally piled up in front of the Stanford bench. And that's a nice play because that play didn't really look like it was going to yield anything but a loss. And Allen turns it actually into a 2-yard gain to the 42. It'll be third and four. With Pitts wide right, eyes set behind Borchardt. And on third down, Joe back, he's being blitzed, steps up, looking, lobbing to the near side for Walters. He's got a 23-yard line. DeRay Lewis with a tackle. There'll be a face mask penalty tacked on. first down, Stanford.
I'll repeat what I said a moment ago. With the game hanging in the balance, don't get too far away from Troy Walters. If we have seen a dominant player this year in Stanford football or any football, it's got to be that little guy.
So that is it was not just an inadvertent. They're calling that a grab of the face mask on the tackle. It's half the distance penalty. So Stanford's going to end up down around the 11-yard line here.
You like to try and run it. And, of course, your attitude in football is let's take it right at them. You know, the game in the balance, let's run right at them. But you can't. You can't get the first down on the ground. You put the ball up in the air to Troy Walters, and somehow that little guy, they couldn't name him Pac-10 Player of the Week 3 weeks in a row, could they? They could. Maybe they'd retire the trophy for him.
All right, first down. Now it's at the 11-yard line of San Jose. Two tight ends for the Cardinal. The lone back is Carter.
Troy's on the right side.
Borchardt back to throw. Steps up. Now to the end zone. Threw it away. Incomplete.
Yeah,
Walters was covered.
Triple covered.
Second down and 10 at the Spartan 11. Borchardt back to throw. Quick slant in the middle, and it's almost intercepted again.
Yeah, I'm trying to hit Walters on that little inside route.
Boy,
that time.
No play today. And Joe Borchardt, a wonderful young man, but no play better exemplifies his lack of football experience in that play. He nearly threw another interception to Samson Sherrod. He hit him right in the hands.
Yeah, big lineman.
They want this ball in the end zone. Third down and 10.
Single coverage on Troy.
Walters.
He's got Lewis again.
And back to throw Borchardt. Borchardt looking, lobbing. One. Walters with a great catch at the 5, and he's down to the 1 yard line. Another flag is thrown late. Walters is right, depending on the mark. Very close to the first down. Let's see where they mark Troy down. And they're going to call this, the Spartans are saying the penalty's against Stanford.
Some kind of movement, maybe?
Well, the flags were thrown down where Walters caught the ball.
He made a great catch. He just could not.
Oh, offensive interference. Wow.
Keep.
Illegal block in the back on the offense, 10 yards from the spot of that foul.
Yeah, that's. That. It was.
Still third down.
Not pass interference,
okay,
but the illegal
right.
block in the back. And Troy, the block wasn't going to help Troy because whatever he was going to do, he was going to have to do all by himself.
Oh, I see. Yep.
Now they get the
over. They got Dave Davis, and that's kind of was a little bit of a chintzy call because the play was already over. Walters was down. Davis hit a guy in the back. That's really a call that you would not like to see make because it had no bearing on the play.
Well, if Bill Dietrich has one route that he has not called today, this is it right here.
Third down at the 12-yard line. They need 11 for a first down. Borchardt back, looking, lobbing to the end zone for Pitts overthrown. And he was well covered by DeRay Lewis. Not much of a chance for a completion there.
Just inside the 20 to make it the 19. 29-yard attempt from the left hash.
Out of Borchardt's hold. Remember, Husak is the usual holder. Not even doing that today. Borchardt out there. There's the snap. Ball down. Kick is up. And it is good. And Stanford has the lead for the first time since the second quarter. Timeout with 11:20 to go in the game. It is Stanford 32, San Jose State 31, and we'll keep it right here during the center deep. Here's Bocelli now with the kick. And this one will not make the end zone. It'll be fielded by Julian at the 3-yard line. Up the middle of the field now to the 15 and knocked down and didn't even barely broke the 15-yard line. Stanford, for the most part, they did allow one run back last week by UCLA for a touchdown, but that's been one of the most improved parts of the Cardinal team this year, Murph, has been kick coverage. All right, first down, Casteller is in the game after being shaken up on the last possession. Under center, Casteller gives on a delay handoff to Morton. Morton trying the right side, wrapped up and brought down for a loss.
Willie.
Matt Leonard, I think, also was there. And a terrific play. Matt Leonard is getting some time now because Real Johnson has not returned to this football game after what appeared to be an injury to his left shoulder. Johnson has not returned. The front 16-yard line. Second down.
Changing it.
Second and 11. Casteller is moving people around. He's got two wide receivers each way.
Stockbauer's in there.
Casteller back to throw in the pocket. Fires down the middle, and it is caught by Pulley for a first down with Primus right on his back. Great catch by Pulley all the way out to the 39-yard line.
Boy, it was
38 yards. 38-yard line of San Jose State with a first down. 32-31, Stanford the lead. Casteller turns, hands the ball to Morton, trying to sweep to the left side, tracked from behind, and that was Willie Howard again.
Yep.
Willie Howard made a great play and brings Morton down for a loss of one.
Morton's pretty fast, but Willie might be just as fast for a big man. He is awesome how quickly he can move. Dave Baldwin, I didn't even ask him. We're talking off the air this morning. We weren't even talking about Willie or his speed, and he just brought, he says, you know, we just have to talk about Willie Howard. He says, he's so quick, I can't believe it.
Six DBs again for the Cardinal, four wide receivers for the Spartans. Kesteller back to throw on second down, wings one on a slant, caught by Green, wrapped up by Faught, but he breaks the tackle, runs across midfield, and is into Stanford territory with a first down. That last possession wins today. 9 minutes and 5 seconds to play, 32-31 Stanford. Kesteller back, blitz, fires over the middle, open man, first down, 39-yard line, LeBlanc.
How often have we talked about that wide open waste area in the middle of that zone, and that's Stanford in that zone that time. Wide open right in the middle, and a perfect throw again by Kesteller. And actually, he's picking them apart right now, Ted.
Yeah, stuck. All right, first down for the Spartans. Morton continues as the back. Now the Spartans have two tight ends out there. Different alignment, and Kesteller, three-step drop. Quick pass near side. Pulley's got it again, wrapped up by Chris Johnson at the 34. So a five-yard first down pass. Pulley, the way he's been used today, reminds me a lot, Murph, of Damian Douglas. We saw catch all those balls for Cal last year.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of the catches, Douglas, maybe those little 2 and 3 yarders that replace the running game.
Exactly. It's an extension of the running game. Stanford playing just a little soft on those corners.
Second down, a long five, 34-yard line. Kesteller with Stanford showing about seven men up front. Here they come, and he throws the ball away down the field. Pulley's out there. It's batted up, juggled, and he caught it. But they say out of bounds. He's ruled out of bounds.
I thought it was a fair catch. Fernandez made a great play.
Wow.
Fernandez made a fabulous play, Ted. With his left hand, he batted the ball up in the air. But I thought the ball had still been caught on a great second effort by Pulley.
I'll tell you, so did I. That's one that if they had replay, I guess replay in the NFL doesn't work on that, but that was a very close play. It was batted, juggled, bobbled, and finally caught by Pulley as he was going out. It looked like he had dragged a foot in. The official was right there.
You only need 1 foot in this game, and he was right there. You can't get a better look at it. Boy, here's a crucial play.
Third down, a long five. I would think this is four down territory for San Jose here. Kesteller has three wide receivers right. Stanford bringing a blitz from Smith. They hand the ball off to Morton up the middle, 30. He ran into a man, and he got the first down, I believe. He might have gone for a touchdown had he not run into his own blocker at the 29-yard line, but Morton got enough for the first down. In the back behind Kesteller, who turns, three-step drop, pump fakes, blitz, and Primus has got him wrapped up and brings him down way back. Kesteller didn't make a good play there. He kept fighting and fighting and lost more yardage because of his fight. They're going to give him the break and mark him at the 39. We're coming down to 7 minutes, and Kesteller takes a timeout.
Yeah, he's got to be tired, too. Kesteller, he's been beaten up. He's been hurt. He's got to be tired.
Stanford Stadium, 7 minutes and 2 seconds to play. Stanford leading San Jose State 32-31 in another wild offensive game. The Spartans come up with second and 20 at the Stanford 39. They have three wide receivers in the game. Morton is the tailback. Tight end Brewer is an H-back. Kesteller under center. He's back to throw. Keeps people in the block. Wings one deep to the near side. He's got a man out of bounds at the 20-yard line.
Short of the first down.
Pulley. Steve Pulley. He has been to Stanford today with Troy Walters. Has been to so many others, they just can't guard him. Troy Walters has been to so many others, they just can't guard him. And he's down to the 20-yard line. It'll be third down and a yard.
Boy, Stanford is just having a terrible time in pass defense, Ted. Terrible time.
14 catches for Pulley for 200 yards. Third and one now, and this, of course, definitely four down territory if Dave Ballman doesn't have faith in his kicker. Third down, Kesteller keeps it straight ahead, and I got close. I'm not sure if he got there. We'll wait for the mark. Kesteller kept it right over center.
Went on the quick snap that time. Catch the defense a little relaxed sometimes when you get that quick snap. I think he made it.
Because he doesn't think 3 points, and I don't blame him.
Courageous
decision. 3 points would be enough to win.
Yep.
Fourth down and a foot, 19-yard line of Stanford. Kesteller over center. Splits out LeBlanc right. Brewer, the tight end left. Morton, the back.
He might throw it.
Casteller under center. Stanford bringing everybody up tight. He takes the ball, keeps it over center, and he got it.
Yeah,
he pushed far enough ahead to get it.
Definitely got it that time, and then he spun out the left side of the pile and got a little more, but I think the whistle had blown by then.
By the way, they're now 3 for 3 on fourth down plays today. Casteller under center from the 18 of Stanford. Goes back to throw. Wings one to the near. So now he's still holding the ball, being pressured and brought down. He snuck his way back near the line of scrimmage. Willie Howard and Stockbauer and Matt Leonard all there. That was a pump and go. They had Pulley do the stop, and then Pulley wanting to go up to the near sideline to the corner of the end zone, but he was never free.
Yeah, Primus and Tank Williams had him pretty well covered that time.
Second down and 11 at the 19-yard line.
Four-man front.
Four wide receivers.
Here they come.
One left, three right. Stanford showing pressure. They're going to run the handoff near side. Great call. LeBlanc, 15, 10, 5, touchdown. Great call.
Ryan Fernandez.
Great call.
Fernandez was the only one that had a chance, and he couldn't get close to LeBlanc. And we talked about LeBlanc earlier. He's a gamer, Ted.
Now by Morgan with 5:28 to go. San Jose State ought to go for two here.
Yeah,
I think
so
that's what they're going to do.
I think so, too.
It's a five-point difference.
Yeah.
From the middle of the field. And they send a guard, Provost, as an eligible receiver out wide right. Casteller now calls a timeout himself. How about that?
Boy.
Well, it looks like he can run it right over center and go in himself. Going to turn, going to fake a handoff, going to bootleg right, throw it in the flat, incomplete. So.
That's a big difference.
Well, it is in that obviously a touchdown now guarantees Stanford the lead. Clock does not move on the failed two-point play, so we'll take timeout, 5:28 to play. 37-32 San Jose State on the Stanford football. All right, a run back here would certainly help as Morgan kicks the ball. Troy Walters will field it near side, 7-yard line, up to the 15, to the 20. Spun around to the 20 and dropped to the 23, so Stanford will have a long way to go. 77 yards, in fact, to go. Plenty of time, 5 minutes, 37-32 San Jose State.
Spartans have been really good on kick coverage today. They've done a great job of containing people like Walters.
Mm-hmm. Both teams over 400 yards in offense. Both teams obviously over 30 points, so it's been much the game we expected.
Troy's not in on the first down play. We got Davis on the right, Pitts on the left, Ted.
Two tight ends with Carter the running back, Borchard under center. Near hash mark, turns, and he's going to hand the ball to Carter, who's hit at the line and dropped. Nothing.
Boy.
San Jose State all over. I mean, they, as if they knew that play was coming. And no Walters on second down. Borchard going to play fake. Drop back, roll, throw on the near side. Errantly thrown and incomplete.
Looking for the tight end.
Yep.
Russell Stewart.
Out in the near flat. First pass thrown to the tight end all day.
Oh, boy.
And it was just poorly thrown by Borchard. Third down and 10.
Something wrong with Troy. Here he comes now. I don't know how you can play without Troy Walters, Ted. I just don't understand that.
Again, with only one timeout left, there is no guarantee Stanford gets the football back.
No, not at all.
They're going to go to a shotgun.
Hard to imagine football without him. They got single coverage, man coverage, left side, Walters far left.
Shotgun, low snap, Borchard fields it. Steps up, steps up, steps up, hits the ball. He's going to be sacked. 18-yard line. Joe just never got rid of it. And Stanford is going to have to punt, three and out on their biggest possession of the day. Counting to play. Here's Tolpenroot's kick. Wobbles near side. Bailey with a fair catch call at the 42-yard line.
It is hard to imagine 11 people without Troy Walters when he has been such an enormous contributor.
Oh, only one time that Stanford can stop the clock. 37-32 San Jose State. Here comes Casteller to the line. He has three wide receivers. Morton is the lone back. And he's going to turn and hand the ball to Morton up the middle. He is to the 45 and brought down. Austin Lee with help from Willie Howard. Green out wide to the right. LeBlanc and Pulley wide left, short side of the field. Morton the lone back again. Casteller trying to use as much time as he can before getting under center. And he's milking that clock. He's going to hand the ball to Morton again. He's hitting the backfield, spins forward, gains a yard, maybe two. Marcus Hoover went in and hit him, tried to knock the ball free. Didn't wrap him up. And Morton got free and bounced off Willie Howard, who finally dropped him at the 46. So it'll be third down and 6. The clock running at 3 minutes. 37-32 San Jose State. So here's one first down. that San Jose State needs to help ensure a win. Stanford needs a stop here to get the ball back. Casteller has Pulley wide left alone against Fernandez. Green wide right. Morton the back, Casteller back to throw, looking for Pulley, lobbing one down the sideline. He's out there, got him on the run. 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown. To 32, San Jose, with 2:33 to go. That is the second touchdown pass for Casteller today, both to Pulley. Extra point is good. We have timeout, 2:33 to go. And now the Spartans have this one in their hands. It is San Jose State 44, Stanford 32 on the display by Steve Pulley. 15 catches. Here's the kick, a dribbler along the ground fielded by Glaspie at the 28. Comes up to the 30, breaks a hit to the 35, and Glaspie runs well all the way out across the 40 with 2 minutes and 24 seconds remaining. The Cardinal hope right now, of course, is to somehow get a big play, score, and then the onside kick, which is what they tried to do last year in the game here against San Jose State, except the Spartans got the onside kick and ran it back for a touchdown themselves. 2:24 to go. 15 catches, 254 yards for Steve Pulley today of the Spartans. He's caught more balls today than he did all of last year. Under center, Borchardt from the Stanford 41-yard line. Borchardt back to throw. Looking, stepping up. Now going to run up the middle. 45, 50. 45 is San Jose and down to the 43. Took a big pop there. Finally brought down, but the ball advancing. They'll stop the clock to move the chains to the San Jose 43-yard line. Still a ways to go here. 2 minutes and 14 seconds. 44, 32. San Jose State the lead. Now Borchardt goes into a shotgun with Davis and Pitts left, Walters right, Joe back, looking, dumps it out over the middle, incomplete, intended for Coy Wire. Borchardt was about to get hit and got rid of the ball so he didn't get hit. So now it'll be second down with 2:07 remaining. Borchardt has only completed 2 of his last 8. He's played the whole way except for one series. Randy Fasani played in the second quarter. Now Joe in the shotgun. And Borchardt takes the snap. Drops back at the 50-yard line. Going to run out to his right. Dump it over the middle. Caught by Pitts. 35-30. Got a block here from Davis. Down to the 20. And out of bounds goes Durrani Pitts to the 18-yard line of San Jose State. So that's a good gainer. And with 1:58 to go, the Cardinal are still alive. But they have to get in the end zone, and again, they've got to get in the end zone and then execute an onside kick, the end zone being the first part of the equation. First down to 10, and of course, the story of this game could be a little bit hard to write, because really the offense has rung up enough points and enough yards to normally win, but really there have been a couple of offensive failures that have hurt Stanford. And of course, the Cardinal defense has not really done much against San Jose. Low snap out of the gun, Borchardt fields it, Borchardt stepping up. Borchardt now throws on the run, caught near sideline, out of bounds. At the 7-yard line, Tafiti Uso, and that's a first down. Just the third ball that Uso has caught this year. It'll be first and goal for the Cardinal with 1:51 to go. Well, this is exactly the kind of offensive drive Stanford would have liked to put together last time they had the ball, when it was only a 5-point game. Gone down the ball or down the field very quickly here and have a chance to put it in with 1:51 to go. Again, the shotgun. Borchardt with Coy Wire alongside. 4 wideouts. Takes the low snap. Borchardt steps up, throws to the end zone. Caught, Walters, touchdown. Near sideline with a man draped right on his back. Jarmar Julian. Troy Walters makes the catch for the Stanford touchdown. So the Cardinal go down the field in less than a minute, in fact. From the San Jose State touchdown to this touchdown, it's 46 seconds. That's all it took. And Borchardt to Walders for the second time today. The extra point will be kicked here by Baselli. There's no need for 2, because that would not have any bearing on the game. The kick by Baselli is partially blocked, but goes through anyway. I think San Jose State got a piece of that ball, but it went through. So we have timeout with 1:47 to play. It is now San Jose State 44, Stanford 39. We'll be back. He's made his way down to the Stanford locker room for the post-game festivities, but before that happens, we have an onside kick coming up with 1:47 to go. San Jose State 44, Stanford 39. Maselli putting the ball on the tee on the near hash mark. He's kicked from the far hash the entire day. But on the onside, he'll kick toward the Stanford bench. He's going to take a short run up. He boots the ball. It bounces high in the air. It hits the San Jose State man, and it's fielded by Stanford. But there is a flag down. Stanford has the ball, but there is a flag down, and I'm going to believe it had to be thrown because Stanford was offside. Wow. What a break that could be for San Jose State. It's against Stanford. The ball glanced off a San Jose State man who ran up in advance of the 45-yard line to try to steal it, and the Cardinal recovered, but here's the call.
Four on the side. Illegal formation on the kicking team. Did not have four players on one side of the kicker. 5-yard penalty.
Well, you heard the explanation right there. That's not a rule that I'm aware of, as Chuck McFerrin elucidated, but what's very unfortunate is that apparently Stanford was not aware of it. And there's a huge mistake by the Cardinal. After recovering the onside kick, the Stanford side, the coaches are just livid. And they are screaming at the officials
with
about the call.
Please set the clock to 1:44.
I've never heard of that rule. But the flag was thrown right away, and so the ball will be put back on the 30-yard line, and Stanford will have to kick it again and hope against hope that they can get that freak bounce one more time. Now the officials are going to convene with some discussion. The man who threw the flag, the back judge, Rich Freitas, and he was the ire of a lot of anger from the Stanford side. They did not like that call at all. Hope that they can get that freak bounce one more time. Now the officials are going to far side in front of the Stanford bench. San Jose State, and as you may, I might expect a lot of their hands people in the game up front. Here's Baselli now with the ball back on the tee. Going to kick it one more time. Takes a high bounce on this one right to the hands of the Spartans. Jamar Julian at the 42-yard line. Casteller under center. 44-39. The Spartans lead it. He turns. He hands the ball to Morton. Morton runs the middle to the 40 and all the way down to the 37-yard line. That's a good gain on first down. And Stanford now takes
timeout, Stanford,
its final timeout with 1:38 remaining. So, State now at the Stanford 37, second down and 5. Again, Morton the lone back. Casteller hands the ball to Morton. Morton trying to bounce through the middle of the line, gets through, and he's got a first down. 30, 25, 20, all the way down to the 17-yard line. Game, set, and match, Spartans. So, Darian Morton, who just became eligible to play and is playing because of the injury to Deontay Whitaker, has carved his own nice little story today. He scored a touchdown the first time he ever had the football in his hands. He's run for 104 yards. And now San Jose State just take a knee three times to ensure themselves a win here for the second consecutive season. At the 17-yard line of Stanford, Casteller was surrounded. He's got a huddle around him of players to prevent any disaster. Goes back, takes a knee at the 20. And the clock now can run with no stop as it hits a minute and counting. And I get the sense from Tyrone Willingham before the game there was some concern about the giddiness over the 3-0 conference start. The knowledge that, of course, this game is always the game that San Jose State regards as it's as, certainly as important as any game they play all year. And the Spartans, I really believe, played with more emotion today. And it's their side of the field right now in the stands. It's obviously going crazy as Casteller comes up at the 20-yard line. Again, he's got a cadre of players surrounding him as he goes back, takes a knee again. As we get down to 23 seconds, and they won't have to snap the ball again. The game is over. And Dave Baldwin, a former Stanford assistant coach, has come back in here for the second straight season and won a game with his San Jose State Spartans as they begin the celebration on the field. And although it is not a conference loss, Stanford remains at 3-0 in the league. It's an extremely disappointing loss as it takes an awful lot of momentum and steam away from Stanford, a team that was looking at a win like this to take another step towards the winning season they'd love to guarantee and the chance of being sure they're included in postseason bowl play this year. Well, the final score here at Stanford Stadium, San Jose State 44, Stanford 39. We're back in 1 minute on the Stanford Football Radio Network.
Hey, Frank.